जय हिंद एवरीवन, माय नेम इज हर्षित सिंह एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द वीडियो। दिस वीडियो इज गोइंग टू बी अबाउट द न्यूली फॉर्म्ड अ लिटिल नोन टेररिस्ट ग्रुप दैट इज TRF, द रेजिस्टेंट फ्रंट। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द वीडियो फ्रॉम द हिस्ट्री ऑफ दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। सो दिस ग्रुप वॉज फॉर्म्ड इन 2019 जस्ट आफ्टर द एब्रोगेशन ऑफ द आर्टिकल 370 एंड द 35A ओके बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया लेड बाय द प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी दैट एंडेड द ऑटोनोमस स्टेटस ऑफ द जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एंड द स्पेशल राइट्स एंड द प्रिविलेजेस दैट वेर इंजॉइंग एज बीइंग द परमानेंट सिटीजन्स ऑफ दैट स्टेट। ओके सो अंडर द प्रेशर ऑफ FATF ISI यूज्ड अ वेरी 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 गुड टेक्निक दैट वॉज टू दे यूज अ न्यू स्ट्रेटजी टू रीब्रांड द मिलिटेंसी ऑफ द कश्मीर एज अ नॉन रिलीजियस मिलिटेंसी। सो दे यूज दिस वर्ड द रेजिस्टेंट फ्रंट। ओके सो द इट इज़ लाइक द ओल्ड वाइन इन अ न्यू बॉटल मीन्स दे यूज द एग्जिस्टिंग कार्डर ऑफ द LET लश्कर ए तैयबा जैसे मोहम्मद हिजबुल अंसर गजवातुल हिंद एंड ऑल दीज ग्रुप्स एंड रीब्रांडेड देम एज इन द नेम ऑफ द रेजिस्टेंट फ्रंट एंड द नेम इज वेरी वेरी वेजडन राइट। अर्लियर द नेम ऑफ द मिलिटेंट ग्रुप्स वेर लाइक हिजबुल लश्कर जैस झांगवी सो दे आर ऑल आर वेरी इस्लामिक नेम्स एंड दे ऑल आर वेरी रिलीजियस and that they often get a criticism from the West. So this time they have used this word the resistant and this word resistant could appeal to the Western countries and they can give a like a, this is something very very indigenous movement and this is non-religious, there is a resistance going on in the Kashmir. Okay, like you have seen in the movie that was Money Heist, there was a resistance. So this is what ISI have done and this is not the first time that this strategy they are using. They have earlier used this strategy in the Myanmar when they were promoting the extremism into the Rohingyas. Okay, so TRF is like a smoke screen that is being used by all the militant groups, mostly by the Lashkar-e-Taiba. Okay, now let's talk about the modus operandi of this group. So, two things that make this group a very lethal group. The first one is that they keep themselves on a low profile, unlike the other militants, other militant organizations. They were like joining the militant ranks and then clicking a picture and with their assault rifle and they're putting it on the social media. And they were usually getting killed in 2 or 3 months. So, if you are following the Kashmir insurgency, you know, since last 4 to 5 years, no militants, no Kashmiri militants, which is not properly termed, could survive for 2 to 3 months, right? So but the TRF has used this new thing that they keep themselves low on the social media, right? They have a very good presence, they have online presence, but they do not reveal their faces, they do not reveal the chain of the command, who is their commander and who is behind all these things. Though they are using Telegram and Twitter sometime to release their statements, their videos and all that. Okay, and the second thing that makes them very lethal that they are using the sleeper cells. Okay, they are not using the hardcore terrorists to carry out the attacks. They are using the overground workers, the people who are very ordinary, they are not who are not on the police radar, so they are very difficult to track. So these two things make them very lethal. And if we talk about the success of this group, what they have done in the past 2 years. So the first known terrorist attack that they have carried in the valley was in the November 2019 when there was a grenade hurled at the civilians, though nobody was killed in that, but 8 civilians were injured in that attack, and this was the first attack that was claimed by the TRF immediately, and this is how they declared the existence of their group. And after that they have had got some huge success in the valley, especially in the April 2020 in the Keran sector of Kupwara, when 5 soldiers of Indian Army got killed and 4 of them were from the special forces, the killing machine of the Indian Army. So that was a huge setback for Indian Army because the ratio was 5 and 5, means 5 militants killed and 5 Indian Army soldiers were killed and 4 of them from the special forces. So that was a huge setback for Indian Army. And the second major success that TRF has received was in the May 2020 in the Handwara encounter, when 5 soldiers including 4 of the Indian Army were killed and that encounter was very, very famous because the colonel of the commanding officer was killed in that encounter. The CO was Colonel Ashutosh Sharma, and Major Anush Sood also included in the killed in action list. So that was also a very, very huge setback for Indian Army. After that, we have seen that this TRF has not been able to carry out the attacks on the hard targets. So they changed their modus operandi and they started carrying out attacks on the soft targets like the unarmed policemen and the innocent civilians, the teachers and anyway, and the political people, means who are affiliated to pro-India parties like BJP. Okay, so they started this, and due to why you have seen this recent killings of the minorities in the Kashmir Valley. Though the killings of the civilians in the Kashmir Valley is not a new thing, if you track the data, then you will find that after 2018, the killing of civilians is not much higher if we compare to the earlier years. But still, because this time they have killed the minorities, the Hindus and Sikhs, so that caused, that instills a fears in the minority community. Otherwise, civilians have been getting killed in the Kashmir Valley and nobody gives a damn. So this is the end of the video, and if you have gained some information and if you enjoyed this video, please like, share and subscribe my channel. So I will bring you more videos like this. Okay, so Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.